How we power each step when we're walking is one of the most important components of doing it with proper technique. And in this video, I'm going to show you multiple simple little exercises that you can use to help make sure you're using the right muscle in the right way to power each step. Hey everybody, I'm Dr. Todd Martin, creator of The Walking Code. On this channel, I try to help you learn how to walk more fluidly, walk with more confidence, and walk with lower impact on your joints. And incorrect use of our hip muscles to power our step is one of the key reasons people have challenges with walking. Whether it's leaning forward, overstriding, or walking with duck feet, improper power is likely at the root of the problem. Make sure to watch the whole video because at the end, I'm going to show you the one simple power trick that you can use to make sure you're correcting your duck feet if that is one of your issues. Let's go ahead and get started. But before we do, make sure if you like this content and my other videos to click the like button, subscribe to the channel if you're not already a subscriber, share the videos, and especially leave me a comment. Let me know what you think of this video and what other content you would like me to produce for the channel for you. For the first exercise, what I want you to do is stand on one leg with the other leg out in front of the body, have vertical posture with a neutral pelvis, so don't let your pelvis tip forward or tip back, nice and neutral. And I want you to lower the body just a little bit, flexing the knee and flexing the hip, and then raise the body back up to a standing position, lower and raise. So as we lower the body down, we are using our glute max in the back of our butt, and we're using the muscle eccentrically, meaning the muscle is lengthening as the hip flexes. Even though the glute muscle extends the hip, it is going to basically slow down the flexion of the hip as we lower. Just like if I had a weight in my hand and I was lowering the weight down this way, that is contraction of the biceps, but it is eccentric contraction of the bicep, which slows down the weight, which would otherwise just fall due to gravity. So we're lengthening the muscle as it contracts. That's what's going on here. We're lengthening the glute max as it contracts to help slow down the lowering of the body. Now we are going to use the glute max concentrically. We're going to contract it to extend the hip as we raise the body back up. So we are lowering the body using the glute max eccentrically, raising the body using the glute max concentrically. Now, a lot of people think when we're walking that we should be using the glute max. You'll hear that a lot. Push off with your glutes. But this is not how the glutes work when we are walking. EMG studies will tell us that the glute max shuts off when we go into the mid-swing phase of gait.
Let's start at the hip joint. At initial contact and foot flat, gluteals are activated concentrically to bring the hip into extension. At midstance, the ground reaction force moves posterior to the hip joint, yet the hip continues moving into extension, thus requiring hip flexors to work eccentrically up until the toe-off.
The psoas muscle in front of the hip is contracting eccentrically as we pull forward into the mid-swing phase of gait. We're going to be able to practice that doing this exercise. Lowering the body using the glute max, and then raise the body using the glute max, lower using the glute max, and then now we're going to use the muscles in front to pull the body forward, and that is going to start us moving into a forward step, the same way we would when we are walking normally. So that is your hip flexors pulling you into the step. Practice that a few times so you can see the difference between pulling and pushing. This is pushing with the glutes, and this is pulling with the hip flexors. That is what gets us going into a normal gait. Now, for people who insist on trying to push with the glute max, what happens is this. Instead of pushing up, which is what's going to happen when we use the glute max, people will push up with the glute max and lean forward. Like that. And that is how they end up using the glute max incorrectly to power each step. Now, there are times when we are going to use the glute max when we're walking, and one of those is going to be when we're walking uphill. This is going to be a great place for you to differentiate between that glute extension and hip flexor action to power the movement, because as we're walking uphill, we're going to use both of these muscles at different times in the gait cycle. So we're using the glute max on my right leg. As I bring the heel down, I'm pushing the body forward and up the hill using the glute max. If I just tried to flex the hip and take away this glute max extension, I'd start falling back down the hill due to the force of gravity. So I need to use the glute max. As I place the heel and go to the flat foot position, my glute max on my right leg here is activated. Now I'm going to use the front muscles in the hip flexors, to pull the body up to a standing position. After we get to the flat foot position, we're going to trade off our glute max extension for hip flexion in the front. And here we're going to use eccentric contraction of the front hip muscles, the hip flexors, to pull the body up into a standing position. So I've actually lengthened my hip flexors as they contracted to pull the body up. And in full contraction, it gets me to this standing position. And from this position, now I have to engage the glute max on that same leg to push the body forward. Glute max on the right, psoas hip flexion on the left, and then now glute extension on the left. Now you'll notice that many people bend over at the waist when walking uphill because they're not using that hip flexion power. They don't know how to use those hip flexors, so they're leaning over like this so they can push up with the glutes on the forward leg and continue to fall forward as they go up the hill. What's going on when people are leaning forward, instead of pulling up with the hip flexors and then moving like that, which is good posture, they lean forward so they can have their center of gravity over the front leg. So now they can push up and then flex the swing leg hip to move it forward. And then they push up, swing the swing leg forward, lean over it, push up, and they go like that. So that is very bad posture, and it's because of improper powering of the movement. So practice from a still position, rear leg extending, supporting the body weight as you get your forward leg to the foot flat position, and then now practice pulling to a stand. This will actually help your posture because this is the core muscle engagement that we use when we're just standing still. Now from this position, we're going to extend from the glutes, change weight, shift to the forward position with the foot flat. I still have an extended glute here on the left. Now I'm going to pull up, extend, and then we alternate. In this next exercise, we're going to help differentiate between hip extension and hip flexion in propelling the body forward by taking a natural step off of a stair onto the ground, and then we're going to step forward from this position. When I'm standing here in this nice balanced position, I have my right hip in flexion, and my leg is rooted on the left, but with no power coming from the left hip. Make sure to keep the lower abs tucking the pelvis so it's in a neutral position. You're not tipped over that way or tucked under this way. Nice neutral pelvis. And then now, let's see what happens if you try to power a forward step by extending from the glute. What will happen is this. Your glute is going to extend the hip backwards in this manner. It's not going to cause your body to go forward like a natural step. But if you instead use the front muscles to power, doing eccentric contraction of your psoas muscle and hip flexors here, it's going to pull your body into that natural leg swing so you can continue a normal gait. Now that we have the idea of how to use the upwards and down, raise and fall, and then pull forward using the hip flexors of the standing leg, let's see what happens when we use the hip flexors of the swing leg to power the motion. What's going to happen is it's going to take a step in this manner, turning the body forward to the camera, even though the rear leg is facing that way, and my forward leg is now going to be turned out. So as I power with the swing leg, that is going to be the action. The leg is going to turn out, not in the direction that the standing foot is facing. Now this foot is facing out in that direction, and I'm going to shift weight onto it and then power with the hip flexors of the rear leg again, and this is the sort of gait that you're going to get. Not only is it going to affect the position that your feet are facing, which instead of being forward, they're going to be turned out at this angle, it's also going to cause your palms to turn backwards because your shoulders are going to internally rotate. So when I'm standing in this position, my arms are in the right position with the correct shoulder action. My thumbs should be facing in the direction my body is facing. But when I swing out by powering with the wrong leg, you can see how the palms turn back. And now my thumbs are facing across the body instead of forward. This is not good for the health of your shoulder joints and your rotator cuff tendons. I hope you enjoyed this lesson on how to correctly power your walk using your hip muscles. If you did, click the like button, subscribe to the channel, and I will see you in the next one. Of course, drop me a comment and let me know what you think.